haters or trolls does not exist anymore. What a scary place the jungle can be. I was just standing here half an hour ago and it was really dark. And then you see that the jungle is actually a scary place. You can't see nothing. And then your brain starts to imagine all the things that could jump out and scare you, or even worse. And I came with some thoughts that I want to share with you, because I think it is something that bothers a lot of creatives, a lot of artists, that in a way they can freeze because they get scared what could happen when they go out into the open, into the art market, want to do their things, but figure out that actually the world out there is a scary place, even a jungle, then that something can jump out of it, and then all your plans, all your great artistic vision could be damaged or turned into dust. And I think one of the most important problems that we are scared of are actually haters or trolls. And I want to share some ideas that I have with you, but I want to share them from a different point of view, because I think that something like haters or trolls does not exist anymore. It could be like 5 or 8 years ago there was something like haters and trolls, but now it is becoming just a strategy. And every artist that is thinking that you are actually dealing with a person that is calling you out, that is hating on you, I think you should think again, because actually this is nothing more. This is a strategy that someone is using to call you out, to get you in the state of freeze, or to distract you, or to have influence on you. And many artists that are successful are forgetting that they have actually a competition. Actually, you can go out there on the internet and buy trolls and haters to cripple your competition. And in the beginning, there have been people perhaps that were haters, but now you can actually go out and buy some to cripple your competition. So most likely, when you are dealing with haters and trolls and so on, think about it. Who has the advantage for crippling your progression? There's always a person, somebody perhaps that is near to you, somebody that is perhaps in the same market like you, that is taking care about the competition, how you are calling it. And to rethink your position and to rethink your steps because of the influence of the competition is not a good idea. So if you want, you can try to really disarm this myth that they are actually haters and trolls out there, because this is a strategy that other people are using. And most likely, when you fear them or you are already having them, someone else is actually using this strategy on you. Because nevertheless, even from your point, from your perspective, there's no way you should care about haters or trolls and so on, because in a way you should not know, or you should not consider haters or trolls. You should only consider players and contributors. When you think about it, who is more likely to contribute to your progression, to your success? They are not the haters, they are not the critics. Of course, critics can be useful, but critics don't express themselves just in a few lines of hate. Critic is about contributing with constructive critique, pointing out things and showing you how to improve them. This is actually a critic. And so the haters and the trolls are actually not critics, and they should not be in your zone of generating an opinion on what you are doing. So right now there are two reasons that haters and trolls does not exist, because first of all, in the time you are living right now, this calling out, weaponized as trolls and haters, is just a strategy that someone else is using on you to go ahead. Someone is just going into an internet farm and just paying for 50 trolls that are bombarding you, social media or whatever it is you are trying to do. And the second thing is, trolls and haters does not exist because they should be outside of your zone of influence. To be able to refocus on the people who are really important to your progression, your friends, your co-workers, the people in your network, or the constructive critics is the most important thing. You should have like 10 other people that you are influenced by in a constructive way instead of listening to just this one person. So I think, I hope that it is an idea that actually trolls and haters don't matter and in a way don't exist. And the other things, the other thing I want to talk about to you is actually when you are not in the position to get rid the haters and the troll out of your mind, or you are already bombarded by it, there's a simple way to get rid of them, because haters and trolls are